it for a bishop or a priest. Yeah. Giovanna Trippi is the personal chef at the Cathedral Basilica in Covington, and she is here with Father Andrew Young yes. of the Diocese of Covington. So good to see you, and they brought some ideas for Halloween.
Yeah,
how you doing, Giovanna?
I'm fine. How are you guys?
Good.
All right. Yeah, I saw the candy and the cookies. I said, hey, I'm pouring in on this interview. But these are very creative, what you did.
Really, some little last-minute ideas, right?
Yeah, this is a last-minute idea, but then the last thing you want to do is something even better for yourselves when the kids are gone.
After the trick-or-treating is over, a little treat for the adults.
I want to show you how to do these real quick.
Okay, so you brought in these little bat.
Right.
I guess they could be desserts or
be
something to do with the leftover candy, maybe?
Anything you want it to be.
Okay.
Those
are cute.
It can be a mustache. It can be, whatever.
Oh, you can make it a mustache? That's a good idea. Look at that.
I hadn't thought about that. Okay.
How do you do it?
Stick it to your...
Yeah. Glue it to your lips. Let's put one on John. No, it's not. I'm just teasing.
So anyway,
you got some little mini Reese's cups, right?
Right. Just some icing on there.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, you guys do it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. One icing
I'll do one.
In there.
You put the bat wings on, John. How about that?
On.
I'll do the.
Okay.
Yeah, they're
all
done.
Right.
Nope.
Yeah.
Okay. You just kind of stick them into the icing.
Into the icing.
Like
that's good.
And then you can put your little red dots for eyes if you want.
Okay. Now you have white ones over there. What are the white eyes? Are those icing eyes or what are those little white candies?
They're just candy.
Okay.
Right now, nobody has them anymore.
Oh, that's so cute.
So
that's really good. Yeah.
I have an artist.
Very nice. Okay. Now before we get to the adult treat that you brought for us. Father Andrew, I want to ask you, Giovanna's, I think, been cooking over there for you, the priests over at the diocese
and
Bishop Boyce for about a year.
Almost,
So how is that for you?
Oh, she's phenomenal. She's fantastic.
You better say that, otherwise she won't eat.
she's wonderful. She's been a real gift to us. And
Well, you've been a priest out in parishes, too. I know you're from Maysville, Kentucky.
Yeah.
That's kind of a special thing. A lot of priests don't, in the rectory there, don't have their own personal chef.
Yeah. Right. There's kind of a group of us that live together, so it's helpful instead of preparing our own meals that she's able to make sure we're eating healthily. So.
Now, in that vein, do you suggest or does she say, no, this will happen the way I say it's supposed to happen?
Yeah.
She pretty much runs the show.
I ask for suggestions. They say, whatever you want to make. Okay.
Well, and I know, and sometimes you cook for people who have maybe some health issues, like they could have a gluten allergy or something like that.
I have two or three of those.
Yeah, and so how does that challenge you in what you do every day?
It's a big challenge, but you have to really prepare. You have to read, and you have to really shop for the, actually I make three different meals sometimes, four different meals, and then somebody will say, is this gluten-free? And I'll say, yes, it is. I'm yelling from the kitchen because, I forget to tell them.
Right.
They can't read it even before they eat it. They have to ask me, and I say, yes, it is, or no, it isn't.
Yeah, but so, it doesn't taste like it's gluten-free. Or
I don't think so, does it?
No. She does a great job of making it taste good.
Good answer.
That's right.
All right. Before we let you go, though, you made a treat for the adults.
Yeah, this is a fun treat. You this could be Christmas, too. You
just dip what is
it
that red stuff?
It's carob.
Oh, with red food coloring in it.
Food
coloring. But it looks like blood for Halloween.
Drip.
Yeah.
And it's just a drip. And then this one is chocolate and with black.
Oh, very nice. Isn't that cool?
And it started to drip like
And you
that.
Have a shaker over here. What do you have in here?
Pina colada.
Pina colada. Okay. What's in that? I see you have some rum here.
There's pina colada over there.
Pina colada mix. Oh, okay. Yeah. Pina colada mix and rum. That's super easy.
Yeah, it is.
Okay.
Then you can pour that for me.
No, I don't know how to pour it.
Father Andrew would never pour an alcoholic
beverage.
The color really adds to it.
Yeah. Isn't that great? Okay. So well, you know what? Giovanna also has a couple of cookbooks called Holy Chow, and you can find those online. She has Holy Chow and Holy Chow Gluten Free. If you have somebody who has a gluten allergy in their lives, thank you so much,
you're
Father
welcome.
Andrew, Giovanna.
Thank you.
Happy Halloween.
Thanks for having us.
I'm glad you're here. Now I don't have to be scared because Father was here.
I've been cooking up all this morning trying to scare. So.
We'll be right back.